boobs. Let's talk about how much your boobs changed. There was no glowing. It's absolutely hilarious and I wasn't expecting that. I always joked I'd write a book about this, but here I am making a video about it now. Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to our channel. If you're new here, I'm Leanne and this is Baby Belle. Today we're going to be talking about all the weird and wonderful and not so wonderful things that happen during pregnancy that they don't tell you about. I'll start with a little disclaimer here. I had a rough pregnancy. I was a walking pregnancy cliche. If there was a symptom to be had, I had it. So if you're looking for a nice fluffy video about pregnancy glow and no morning sickness, I'm afraid this isn't the video for you. It's not all bad. I definitely don't want to scare anybody, so there are plenty of funny and nice things in it, I think. If you are sticking around to watch, thank you. And if you enjoy our videos, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss our future ones. There seems to be so much that they don't tell you about pregnancy. It's like it's some secret club or something. So I'm going to share with you all of the things that took me by surprise. A lot of these are sort of like throwaway lines in films or in TV shows and stuff, and you just think, oh yeah, whatever. But then when it actually happens to you, wow. We'll start with that famous pregnancy glow. I did not glow. I don't know what the opposite to glowing is, but that was me. I had dandruff. I had horrendously dry skin that I just wanted to rip off all of the time. I tried so many creams and the only one that worked for me was an Aveeno one. That was like my entire first trimester. I was just a mess. Add to that sickness and all of the other things that we're about to discuss, and yeah, there was no glowing. They don't tell you how difficult it is to keep it quiet when you find out that you're pregnant, and if you find out really early like I did, it was like about 4 or 5 days before my period was due. It's then 9 weeks of keeping it quiet before you have your first scan, and it's so difficult. You're so excited to tell everyone and it's just like, oh. And especially as well, if you're having somebody else that's celebrating, just finding out they're pregnant and everything and telling everyone, and people are like, oh, when's it your turn? And I'm like, oh, well, actually, morning sickness. I do not know who came up with the name morning sickness, but whoever did had obviously never experienced it in their entire life. It is not morning sickness. It is all day sickness, and it can be horrendous. Obviously, I'm not saying that that's going to happen to everyone. Like I said, I don't want to scare anybody. You might be absolutely fine and not have it at all. I had sickness all day and it would get worse from the moment I woke up until I went to bed. I was also really, really unfortunate to be sick for my entire pregnancy. I think there was about 2 weeks, somewhere around 16, 17 weeks where I wasn't sick, and then it just came back in full force. But I just thought morning sickness was, you'd wake up in the morning, feel a bit sick, you might throw up, and then you'd go about your day as normal. Yeah, that did not happen to me. It was terrible. And a lot of people were like, oh, I think I'd rather be sick than feel nauseous. I'm like, I'm on, you know, day 95 of being sick 7 times a day. I can guarantee you that being sick is not nicer than just being nauseous. As I said, this doesn't happen to everyone, but I wasn't aware that it would go on for so long. You go onto Google and it's like, oh yeah, you know, it peaks at 9 weeks, you'll be fine by 12, and you get to 11 weeks and you're like, yes, 1 week to go. And then you get to 13 weeks pregnant and it's still going, and you get to 16 weeks pregnant and you just accept the fact that actually that's just going to be you for the next 9 months. But with that, I didn't have any pregnancy cravings at all. Absolutely nothing. So again, you will hear all the time about everybody gets pregnancy cravings, food cravings. I didn't have anything. I just wanted to be able to eat normally, but there wasn't anything that I was just like, oh my God, you need to go and get me this now. No pregnancy cravings at all. Isabel, what are you doing? Are you snuggling the pillow? Another thing I found odd was that people felt like they could just comment on stuff that they wouldn't normally. So like suddenly your sex life just becomes an open discussion. Like, oh, was it planned? How long were you trying for? That sort of thing. And also people want to touch you as well. Hey. Luckily, I was pregnant through pretty much the whole of lockdown, and then COVID restrictions were in place, so I didn't have random people coming up and touching me, but I did still have a lot of people asking me all those questions, and I'm like, okay, I found that I wasn't overly emotional. Now, I'd seen a lot of things that people were like, you know, they'd burst into tears all the time, or they were just really, really emotional. But for me, I was just the same as I normally was. I did have a couple of days where I was a bit teary and a couple of days where I was a bit, probably a bit angry, but it wasn't anything worse than when you get a bit of PMT. So you don't necessarily get that. And I thought that was a bit strange as well. But pregnancy anxiety, that's terrible. From that moment when you find out that you're pregnant until your 12-week scan, you've got absolutely no idea whether your baby is okay in there. You've got absolutely no idea. So that anxiety of wondering whether everything is okay is really, really bad. Those first 12 weeks, and obviously because you haven't told anyone, there isn't anyone that you can really talk to about it either. So it was just, I could only talk to John, my partner, and obviously he doesn't want to hear me going on all the time about how I'm worried because I don't know what's going on in there. Obviously my worries were unfounded, as you can see here, but that anxiety just went through the whole of my pregnancy. Every time I had a scan, it was awful. And it doesn't really change once they're out as well, because you're still worrying about what they're up to, and I'm guessing that's just going to go on forever now. Boobs. Let's talk about how much your boobs change. So for me, they were my first indication that I was pregnant. As I said at the beginning, I found out that I was pregnant really early. I think it was about 5 days before my period was due, and the reason for that was because my boobs had changed so much. So they really hurt. Like, they would hurt normally in the run-up to my period.
You alright over there?
But this time they were really, really painful, and veins as well, like veins pop out all over the place, and my nipples hurt and they were changing colour, to the point where I was looking at photos from a holiday a couple of years ago where I was in a bikini and being like, oh wow, yeah, like they're, you know, that really, really different. So that was my first indication that I was pregnant, and those changes just, they carry on throughout pregnancy. And then obviously once you've had the baby, if you are breastfeeding, they don't go back to normal as they were. So I've no idea when mine are going to go back to normal, but boobs, they change so much. You hear a lot of things about how your sense of smell increases and changes, but what they don't tell you is that things smell disgusting. I could not stand the smell of our fridge, to the point where I'd have to take a deep breath before I opened it. It was cleaned out with bleach, it was cleaned out with bicarbonate of soda, it chucked everything away and replaced it. But for 12 weeks, the smell of our fridge was disgusting. And it was the same with the dog as well. I feel really, really sorry for her, but I couldn't have her near me because she smelled horrible.
What's the matter?
And just everything in general, like we had the carpet cleaned and I still thought it smelled horrible. I went outside. I mean, don't even get me started on fish and stuff like that. Anything like that. Oh, it was just awful.
Hey. Hey, beautiful.
But with that as well, you get like the pregnancy cold or the blocked or runny nose, which is absolutely bizarre. So it's like having a cold, but you can smell everything. Tiredness. Oh my God. For that whole pregnancy, I was absolutely knackered. Like, the tiredness was unreal, especially in those first 12 weeks.
Hey.
It was absolutely bizarre. I can't even explain how tired I would get. I think a mixture of obviously pregnancy and hormones and the sickness as well. I was just wiped out all the time.
Hello.
Hello. Scan pics. So you expect to get some really cute pictures of your baby when you go for your scan. In this one's case, she wouldn't look at the thing that they used to scan. She was really camera shy, which if you look at her now, you definitely wouldn't believe that. But we were expecting to have all these, bless you, we were expecting to have all these really nice scan pictures, and yeah, she didn't look at it at all. I actually had to go back a couple of times to have scans done because they couldn't get to her face because she was hiding away, weren't you? And now look at you.
Yeah.
Stretching pains. Stretching pains are a thing that nobody told me about.
Oh, it started to rain.
As your uterus is growing, you get all of these weird pains in there everywhere, and it's just absolutely bizarre. But as well, you also get fart pains or gas pains, which are horrendous, and the wind that you get from being pregnant, especially in those first 12 weeks in that first trimester, it's absolutely hilarious. And I wasn't expecting that, and I don't think John was either, but fart pains are unpleasant. And to go with that, the amount of times that you need to pee. Now, you expect that later on when, you know, the baby's taking up all the room, but for some reason, from the moment I was pregnant, I just needed to pee all of the time. It was bizarre. And I think it's just, you know, everything starts moving around in there, but there is literally nowhere for your organs to go. And you end up with, you know, your lungs are up here and your stomach's about that big and your bladder's about that big and getting bounced on. And it's just absolutely bizarre. And if you look at any of those pictures, you can see like all your organs have been moved away around and you can understand it, but you end up out of breath and, you know, you can't eat anything because food, there's nowhere for the food to go and you just need to pee all of the time. You won't necessarily get piles during your pregnancy. They wait until labour and then they take forever to go away.
You're the one that caused them.
I didn't get any during pregnancy, but I definitely did during labour. So you don't necessarily get them during pregnancy, but don't think just because you didn't get them then that you've got away with it. They can just suddenly appear. Pregnancy brain. Pregnancy brain is a thing, and then it turns into baby brain. And I don't actually know when I'm going to get my normal brain back, but...
Hey. What's the matter?
Pregnancy brain is a thing and it doesn't go away when you have the baby. It then turns into baby brain and it is just weird. I found that I would be talking to someone and I just completely forget the word that I wanted to say and I'd just be there like, yeah, no idea what I'm talking about. So pregnancy brain is definitely a thing and baby brain is a thing. And I think that lack of sleep plays a big part in that as well, but also those hormones too. And plus, I'm pretty sure that this one has just stolen any intelligence that I once had, didn't you? Swollen and bleeding gums was something that I was not expecting. Now again, I know that they'll say that you can experience swollen gums, but mine were horrendous. They were so swollen, it was unreal. I'm guessing that's the reason why you get a free dental treatment in the UK. Not that that's really any help, because trying to get an NHS dentist these days is ridiculous. Heartburn. So heartburn is up there with morning sickness, one of the things that people tell you about and actually do talk about, but my God, it can be awful. I ended up on so many different medications because of my sickness and my heartburn, and I had food reflux where food would just come back undigested and it felt like it just sat in my stomach forever. So that mixed with the heartburn. Yeah, I've never experienced heartburn before in my life and oh dear, it is unpleasant. But if you do suffer with heartburn, don't suffer in silence. Try all of the stuff that you can buy from the shops and then if it doesn't work, ask your doctor for omeprazole. Fantastic stuff. It didn't get rid of my heartburn. Oh, what's going on with my hair? Didn't get rid of my heartburn completely, but it did help manage it. Bum hiccups. Bum hiccups are a thing. So when the baby is big enough and upside down and they get hiccups, and she had hiccups all the time, you can feel it in your bum and you can feel it in your cervix. It is the most weird feeling ever. And then obviously you can see it as well. When the baby's got hiccups, you can actually see your belly moving, but I wasn't expecting that I could actually feel it in my bum. It was just so strange. But that moment when you feel them move for the first time and all those little kicks and everything, that is just amazing. To start with, I kind of thought it was just... Oh, you've done something with the microphone. To start with, I thought it was just fart bubbles. And then I realised I started feeling her quite early, about 16 weeks, even though I had an anterior placenta. I did start feeling her move. And yeah, it's just such an amazing feeling. And that's probably... one of the only things that I miss about being pregnant is that feeling of her moving around. It is fantastic. Oh, what's the matter? Then on the other side of that as well is that the baby will be active all night. As soon as you sort of settle down to sleep, for some reason, that's when they wake up. I'm guessing it's all of that movement during the day. They like that. It rocks them to sleep and then they're awake. But then if they do have a night... Are you okay? If they do have a night where... or they do have an amount of time in the night where they're not moving around as much, then get really worried, and that's just that pregnancy anxiety thing again. Oh, you can't be tired, you've just woken up from a nap. Not being able to deal with heat is another thing that I struggled with. Now you might find that quite funny because I'm in the UK and we don't really get that much heat and sun, but I really enjoy being outside in the sun when it's warm in the summer. I absolutely love it, but during pregnancy I could not stand it. The sun made me feel sick. I was hot all the time.
Oh, you've got lipstick on.
We had a couple of days in the summer last year where it was sort of like 32 or 33 degrees and I just couldn't cope with it. Normally I would have loved that, but oh, it was terrible. I just laid there with like cold wet towels on me trying to deal with it. So the sun and the heat are, and pregnancy, they don't go together at all in my opinion. Landscaping, you're not going to be able to do it yourself once you get your bump gets a certain size, and it's not like, you know, when you've put on a couple of pounds and you can just sort of move anything out of the way so that you can see what's going on. Your bump's pretty solid and there's no way you can just move it around to try and get everything, so you can't see what's going on down there. And if you're like me, I wasn't willing to take a razor down to any sensitive areas that I couldn't see. And it was something that I worried about during my whole pregnancy. I was like, oh, I'm going to go into labour and everything's going to be all unkempt and everything. But I can't even remember what the situation was when I went into labour. And I think I had about 35 people that were involved in my labour. So, you know, I worried about my lady garden for absolutely nothing because I've got no idea what state it was in at that time. When the baby starts moving around a lot as well, they kick things off of your belly. So I can remember I sat there reading Kindle, had my Kindle resting on my bump and baby Belle just kicked it off. And that's funny. It's so cute. And that's one, again, like I said, that's one of the things I miss about being pregnant. Stretch marks aren't guaranteed. Now, you hear people talk about, you know, you're definitely going to get stretch marks, your body is going to be ruined, blah, blah, blah. First of all, stretch marks aren't ruining your body. They are your tiger stripes. You've grown a baby, but they're not guaranteed. And that was one of the good things about my pregnancy is that I didn't actually get any stretch marks. And I moisturised every day, but I do think, what's the matter? Oh, how are you tired? I do think that it is a genetic thing. Turning over in bed becomes something that has to be carried out with as a military operation. It's like executing an 18 point turn. It's absolutely bizarre. And just getting comfortable in general in bed as your bump gets bigger just becomes horrible. So I'm guessing that's just, you know, preparing you for the lack of sleep once the baby's arrived. Although nothing can prepare you for that. Nothing. SPD and sacroiliac joint dysfunction can happen really early. Mine kicked in around, I think it was about 16-17 weeks. It was really painful. My SPD didn't kick in till around 32 weeks, but at that point I could barely walk. I wasn't expecting to have so many back problems so early on. And the same with sciatica as well. I went through a stage of having that from about 16 to 22 weeks. And I wasn't expecting it to be that soon. Gestational diabetes as well. You don't have to be unhealthy to get things like that. I was really, really fit. Hey, we're nearly done. Hey. I was really, really fit before I fell pregnant. There seems to be this perception that only people that are overweight or unhealthy get GD, and that couldn't be further from the truth. I was only tested for it because of my age. Once you're over 35 in this country, they test you for GD, and I had it. I didn't find out until I was 32 weeks, and to be honest, it really, really threw me. I thought it was something that was just linked to... What's the matter? I thought it was something that was just linked to being overweight, but it can happen to anyone, and it doesn't mean that you've done anything wrong. Oh, what's wrong with you? People will tell you their labour horror stories without you even having to ask them. As soon as they find out you're pregnant or your due date starts approaching, just unsolicited, they will tell you their labour horror stories. Now, don't get me wrong, I am planning on sharing my labour story with you soon, and that is definitely a horror story, but I won't just be chucking it out at you. It will be in a video clearly labelled that it's a traumatic labour story. But yeah, everybody would just tell me their horror stories. It's just like, oh, okay, thanks for that. And they also say stupid stuff like, enjoy your pregnancy, make the most of this time, get as much sleep as you can. Oh, take more pictures. Make sure that you take as many pictures and videos as possible. I didn't take that many when I was pregnant and I regret it. And document everything, write everything down, because although you're in it at the moment, you forget so quickly. You forget everything, and it's just, I had a journal with everything written down, but I didn't take. You need to go to sleep. I didn't take too many pictures or any videos, and I really regret that now. So just take, document everything and really make the most of it. I'm not going to tell you to enjoy it, because if you're not enjoying it, then people telling you to do that isn't going to change anything. But just savor the moment, and so that you've got time, so that you can look back in future. I didn't massively enjoy my pregnancy. I couldn't. I had a lot of things that went wrong, but as you can see, it's all worth it in the end. Isn't it? As usual, we really hope that you enjoyed this video and found it useful. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button and leave us a comment. It lets YouTube know that the video is worth sharing to other people and it makes us really happy. We'll see you next time. Say bye. Do you need a nap again already? Do you need a nap? Hey? Oh look, you're all quiet now. Real quiet now that we finished filming. Hey, oh no. Look what you've done.